Hello, hello, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO Creator set for summer 2014. This is the Bike Shop and Cafe. It comes with 1,023 pieces, and this is a 3-in-1 set. So thanks in this case to the building prowess of my wife, you will be seeing all three versions of this in this one video. So here we are with the default build that gives the set its name. You've got the Bike Shop and you've got the Cafe, and there are multiple things kind of built into this. I want to give you just kind of an overview of what this thing looks like, what the size is, what the kind of scope of it is. You can see the buildings are actually very, very thin when you have them fully splayed out like this to kind of make a nice long kind of street side display like this. Turn this around and you can see that they've got details on the backs, and we'll look at those a lot more closely. And you can just see how these things are just kind of double wide. They are actually hinged in the center. Each one of these is hinged, so we can bring these together. I can take this one and fold it up like so. I can take this one and I just had a little thing to hold it together. Fold that up like so. These now become much smaller. Turn this around like this, bring them together, and that makes for just a smaller, you know, more compact version of the same buildings. So here's a look at all that up close, and we'll start with the Bike Shop over here just so you can see a little bit more closely the front. A little bit of awning there with some olive green color. You can see the bike on a huge display, nice angled display up front. They do have small little foliage bits, you know, little potted plants all around this thing to give it a little extra life. Balcony across the way above the cafe over here, that's supposed to represent a sign to kind of show that it's kind of like a coffee shop kind of setup, I guess. You have one table outside with the single chair there. And on the roof of this thing, it actually has a little brick-built bird up on the top. Turning this around to the side, you can see you could kind of treat this as a street corner right here. So you've got a main street coming down this way, and then the street would actually turn. You can pretend that this is the sidewalk going across here. So this is now another street. You can just imagine you're going down. Nice ATM, very nicely built up ATM there. I'd say one of the nicer designs of ATMs that LEGO has actually officially put into a set. Got a little different thing on the back of the sign there showing what would be a cupcake, I'm assuming. On the back of the cafe, you've got stairs going up to the top. Got a little housing unit up above there. You also have a back door to the place, back door to the upper level. The roof doesn't have much on it, but we will look at that from the top in a second. And then on this other building over here with the bike shop, again, you've got a rooftop balcony. This one actually does have a little barbecue grill up there. And down the side, just a kind of a roll-up style of door in the back. It actually flips out, but it kind of looks like a roll-up door with little stairs going up to it. There's a better look at the roof over the bike shop, and just a little bit more look at the roof over the cafe. Let's look at that from the other side. Well, there you go. You can kind of see that there's some foliage growing up there. Also, some kind of weird looking plants. I don't know if those are supposed to be snapdragons or something. I don't really know what they're trying to go for with the orange there. Almost looks like upside down carrots, but there you can also see the little brick built bird a little bit better. Let's open this thing up so we can see the inside of it and take a better look at the details, especially from the back. Looking down here, this is the front section of the cafe there, where you just have a little table with a nice light above it. Nice curtain detail with the medium blue colors coming in from the sides. Just a little, looks like bottled water on that side. And this is the opposite side of the room here. Remember the whole thing, clamshells open in the center. And this is the register section. This is where you'd actually go up to get your food. You can see the little cupcakes that were represented by the sign out front on one side are shown right here, with a little bit of a display case kind of set up. And then you've got the coffee machine or espresso machine over on this side. That's not really supposed to represent any kind of memorable detail. It's just part of the mechanism that locks both halves together. This clip over here on this side, this brick, modified brick with the clip in it, will lock into that to keep both of these together if you want them to stay together. And then up above, this is, like I said, just kind of a small little housing unit, like a very small apartment very little furniture in there, very little space. You also notice they kind of approximated a sort of a ladder going up here, and this is able to open up, so that's how you're able to get minifig access to the roof, if you like. This is a nice, small little drawer, table kind of thing, and a nice lamp on there. And on the other side is nothing but just a chair, and then you've got access to the balcony. This door here opens inside, which it really needs to do, because you don't have enough space to open a door out this way. And then on that balcony, you've just got just the little banister and a little bit of, again, just the foliage, just to spruce it up a little bit. Here's the bike shop, and let's go ahead and open that up. And this is able to lock in the open position on this particular version. Spin her around and take a better look at the details inside here. First of all, we'll come down to the lower level, and this is the front of the bike shop where you saw the bike there. It's on this inclined plane here. It just has a little bit of a hinge down here that's able to, you know, keep that thing in that rectangular, almost squarish space. This is the register in this case, just a single printed piece. And then back here you've got the little workshop area. So this is where they would be working on bikes. So you have a couple of minifig tools back here, just a little, I guess, storage area underneath of there, and a rack or ramp, which also provides access to the rear roll-up door, which is this one that flipped open that I mentioned before, just kind of your cargo and freight kind of access there. And this one single clip right here is intended to hold a bike. So if you're working on it, you can hold the bike kind of at an angle. And then to access the upper floor on that side, you have nothing but a ladder. So your ladder is going to take you from the bottom up to the second floor, and it's also ultimately going to take you up to the roof, where they just have these little pull open, almost cellar style doors up here, which just lets you get up there to take a break and do some barbecuing. But there's more detail at this level. Looks like it's a little bit of a kind of a kitchen setup here. You got some drawers. You do have what looks like a stove there, so I guess that this is maybe supposed to be part of an oven. You've got a sink over there, which actually has a basin, and then this is supposed to represent a small little drawer over here beneath the sink. And across from that, you've got a bedroom, the most simple of bedrooms. It has some lights up above, which are actually pretty nice looking, but then just a bed. You know, it's just kind of showing you that you've got the ability to have your bike shop owner or owners living here. You know, it's really not the greatest of accommodations, but it gets the general idea across. And for such a small space, they put a respectable amount of detail in there. With all that main build, you also make this car. Very small, quirky, semi-sporty, somewhat classic looking thing with the sloping front. It's all brick built. It's not based around any, you know, standard city car chassis or anything like that. It's really built up pretty well, and it has a clip on the back to allow you to attach a bicycle there. So if you want to be bringing your bike in to the shop, you can bring it in on your car, on the back of the car. I also want to show what this looks like with the minifig in there, because he actually sits up very high in the thing, and it really helps to bring the scale to the whole thing to show you just how small it is. And it's really accentuated by how high up he sits in it. Before we move on to the next build, here are the three minifigures that are included with this set. These are all pieces that we've had before. Absolutely nothing new here as far as I can see. Just, you know, recycled stuff. But this is Creator, not City. So it's really about doing things that are fairly generic and can be used for many different purposes. You'll also note that none of these have secondary faces under there. They're all just single face heads. This build yields an auto repair shop, probably the oldest, kind of most classic looking version of the building out of the three official possibilities for this set. Pretty nice with the windows going around to the side, so no really unused space, no undecorated space. Once again, a balcony up top, and yeah, this is looking pretty good from the outside. Has nice, you know, nice little facades and details around on the outside. I appreciate very much. And of course, you've got this diagonal window, which is kind of the distinguishing feature here. This is your garage area. Very nicely done with the sign there. Now let's go ahead and open this up and see what we get inside. All right. So this over here is kind of the front, you know, the customer facing area, kind of the lobby waiting room area. I mean, the whole thing is so small that, you know, you're not going to have a lot of open space, but they do have a little pathway to get into the garage, which makes sense. That's how most auto garages that I've seen are set up, especially small ones. You can get directly into the service bay. This is the checkout register here once again, and then across from that or behind that, this is still continuing the back half of the garage section. And you could kind of use this as either a mail drop or as just a storage container. And then you've got the little workshop over here, which has just some tools built up, some interesting looking things. And of course, you got your tool cabinet down below. And for access upstairs here, you once again get a nice little ladder on the side, which brings you up through this hole. There's another ladder that's going to take you up to the roof if you want to go up there. And once again, we have this just opening flap up on the top. Not as much going on the roof there. Nothing going on here. This just opens up to a small little balcony area. And this is kind of an office. So this is the upstairs office for the repair shop. And it has the medium blue colored coffee maker. I've not seen them make a coffee maker in that color before. And you've got a light over there, which I'm assuming you can just kind of rotate that around to be for the desk. As a matter of fact, let me just do that right now. Just turn that, something like that, I think would work out. Well, however you want to do it. And then up here is what you get for the roof with just a small little flower garden off towards the corner area. So let me bring this back together so you can see exactly how that all fits together. So there's your roof opening hatch. Nothing back in the back, and then it's mostly just that front corner that gets all the action. With the repair shop build, you also end up making a different vehicle this time. This is kind of a, it looks like a small pickup truck, and it's a service truck. That's what I'm assuming, given that it's got the lights up top. Pretty boxy little thing, but you know, it's a good use of the parts for a creator set. Such a small thing, using pieces that are normally used as part of the buildings with the other builds, I think that this is a good use, and it makes sense looking at it. And it could be, you know, kind of the fast response vehicle that's owned by the same folks that also run the shop. So they would be able to do roadside assistance with this. This is nice. This is looking more like a full-sized modular build here for sure. And yeah, it's just got a nice shape to it overall. You know, it's has a similar depth to width. And basically what you have here is a flower shop at the bottom and an apartment unit at the top. And I think they go together really well. They make good use of a good number of the colors included in the set without making anything clash too much. This over here on the side is just the walkway up to the upper unit. You also have a ladder that comes down that gives you access to the roof if you want to get up there. This looks like it's supposed to be just a little fountain on the side. I think it's more decorative than anything. You've got some random flowers out here that you can pick from. Nice awning once again. Good open entranceway with everything being as bright as it can be on the inside because everything is covered with windows there. So let's go ahead and see what it looks like on the inside. Just pull these apart, open that up, and there we go. Kind of the dollhouse effect once again. Let's look at the shop. This is the front section of it. So that's the front door there, or I believe you'd call that the front door. Just small little details used here. You know, there's not a whole lot of space available in this thing to put lots of big complicated things, so they did what they could. Also have an aeration kind of spray bottle there just to help keep those products fresh, the flowers themselves. On the opposite side over here, this is the back half of the store. You've got some more special little things underneath and behind this display case. I would expect this would be where they would have orchids and corsages and things like that. It might be a little refrigerated display case. And this is the register right here. So that's just the register section. And then you've got the door in the back, which is pretty much for employees only. Up on the second level, this is the front area of the apartment unit. Nice door. The door does open inward, like so. You can see what that looks like from there. And all you get there is just a couch. I think that's what this is supposed to be, a couch or a love seat or something like that in the front main room. Just not much that you can do. Well, it's really the only room, but it kind of looks like two rooms when you open it up like this. And over here, they just have a table, and there's a mug on there, and you have access to the roof from here also. So you can get to the roof from inside or from out. There is the roof, since I've mentioned it a few times now. That's your little flap for getting to it from the inside. And I'll just bring these back together so you can see the full shape of what that looks like when it's all together. That's actually pretty nice. You have a good amount of variance of textures and size and shape of things. That's a really good looking little roof detail, I would say. You got the small little smokestack on this side. Not really gonna be doing anything in this particular model, but I think it just looks good. I also appreciate the small details that they have on the outside with the nice large lamp here, small lamp on this tiny little balcony, not even enough space to really stand there, but just good use of random small little pieces. This is a lighted section above this rear door, and they even have a little outlet, little water outlet back there for washing some stuff off. So there you have it, all three versions, and I figured I would bring us back to the box art kind of primary version of the set to sum everything up. I'm pretty happy with this one for the number of pieces. It's really, really like a mini modular kind of thing, but in minifig scale. It allows you to have some interesting, good-looking, well-designed buildings that fit into very small areas. Not everybody has enough room for storage and display of the big, big modular buildings. Not everybody wants to pay the kind of money that it costs to get multiple full-sized modular buildings, and this allows you to get a lot of that look, a lot of the different colors, you know, the higher level of design than you see with the city sets, a more complex build for a lower cost and in a much smaller space. I think they do a really good job of that. If you're looking for something on the scale of the full-size modular buildings, obviously this is not going to do it for you. The third of the three versions that we looked at was, you know, the best that you get for a single building here. Each of these others, they're just really thin. Fold them together, you know, takes up some more space. But if you're looking for a big, massive impact, obviously this is not going to do it for you. But for keeping everything small and compact and just succinct and to the point, I think they've done a really good job. And they've given you three respectable different options to build. Of course, you can also use your own imagination to come up with different ways of mixing these same parts together to make something even still different. But anyway, those were my thoughts about this set. I hope that you enjoyed this look at the thing, and I hope that you will share your thoughts about the set in the comment section. Feedback is always appreciated. I'm gonna go build some more stuff with my wife, and we're gonna bring you more videos and more cool Lego stuff to check out. So follow the blog at JANGBRiCKS.com to make sure that you're on top of everything that I'm doing. You can see what's coming up. You can also see some stuff that won't be showing up on video at all. And I'll be talking to you again very soon. Bye for now.